Filmstro. Before we begin the review and demo, let's listen to a few audio samples from Filmstro. Hi, my name is Arun, and in this video, we will see a detailed demo and review of what is Filmstro, how to use it, what's the pricing, how you can get a Filmstro lifetime license, and how to customize the royalty-free music tracks and much more. Now, before we get to the demo, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already and do give this video a like so this video can reach more people. Some of you might be wondering what is Filmstro. Let's say you need a royalty-free soundtrack for your video projects, be it YouTube videos, online course videos, wedding videos, short films, anything, or maybe for audio projects such as podcasts and audiobooks. There are some good music available from various free sources, and even YouTube's audio library is there, but not everyone is comfortable going that route. That's why it's good to have a service without any worry of copyright strikes or other royalty-related problems. So here's where Filmstro comes into picture. It has a library of royalty-free music composed by real musicians. The tool has a simple timeline with three sliders that allow you to adjust the core fundamentals of any music track. The momentum, so it could be fast or slow music, and the depth, to have it as high or low tunes, and the power, be it soft music or strong and heavy music. This is how any music track can be customized to your liking with various variations. Speaking of Filmstro's pricing, you could get an annual or monthly subscription to use all their music covered worldwide and in perpetuity. Use them for as long as you want. Currently, there is an offer going on for a limited time to get this tool for just $59 as one-time fee, and it's a lifetime price if you want to use it for just for the YouTube videos. If you want to invest for a long time, on the other hand, into your future creations as well, that can be a good investment where if you want to use it for online and broadcast ads like Facebook ads or Google ads and then games, or maybe even YouTube ads, or if you are going to create mobile applications, mobile apps, you can use them within apps, and radio or corporate videos and wedding videos, be it for yourself or your clients, you can get their Pro Plus version, the Pro Plus plan, for a one-time fee of $118 now, and you can get a lifetime access to their software. Now, these links are given in the description below. If not, just go to techlibrary.tv/filmstro. I already grabbed a copy of their Pro Plus plan and I'm loving it. Let's now see how to use Filmstro to get royalty-free soundtracks for your projects. There are two ways to access the Filmstro's music tracks. They have an online music library and a desktop app to install for PC or Mac. An online music library is given so we can browse their tracks online to listen and choose whatever audio tracks we want. It also gives their meta values about the track, such as the key, tempo, and other useful tags describing the audio track itself. Simply browse the website, choose what you think suits your project, and download to use them. We will see all that in the demo in the next few minutes. When it comes to licensing, the tracks that we use are all listed neatly inside your account within a downloadable license in PDF format. So let's now begin by starting the Filmstro standalone app. So as soon as you open the Filmstro app, the standalone desktop app, I'm using it on a Windows computer right now. You will see that there are four sections on top of your left hand side of the screen. The collections, favorites, downloads and search. These are pretty self-explanatory, where in collections you can find all the different types of music tracks organized by playlists, featured ones, mood, film and video genre, instrumental palette, and music genre. So under new tracks, you can see that there are new tracks that are available and added every single week. These are marked by this blue icon over here. Now the playlist section is my favorite part, where you can find a good lo-fi beats and popular trailers and stuff picks, which are pretty decent and can be used in a variety of projects. And now whichever track you like, you can just hard them here, and which is what we will see under the favorite section. So you can see that I have favorited this Maniok, and this got added under my favorites tab. And under downloads, whichever track we choose to download will get added to the downloads, which is now will be available in our local for editing. And in search, obviously we can search the name of the music track. If you know the name of the track after you stumbled on it, maybe on the web app, so you can search them to find them here. Or you can just simply search whatever you would like to that comes to your mind, and then you may hit on a random track which you may find great. So these are the four sections, main sections here. And on the left side bottom corner, you will find three sliders. These are the I would say this is the heart of Filmstro, where we'll have those three slider options for each, for momentum, depth and power. This is what we are going to use to control the tempo or the high and low of any music, so that it can suit to our scenes or our needs. With this, I would say that we can create multiple variations which might have a lot of probability. So you can create hundreds of different sounding tracks with the same single track, or maybe you can even mix multiple tracks together. And on the right side here, you will see the editing section, where if you're going to import a video, this is where it shows up. And at the bottom, there are a simple couple of buttons which says that if you click on this create, you can either import a video or work with only the soundtrack. When we want to import a video, currently Filmstro Pro supports only the MP4 version. So click on this to import your MP4 videos to start editing and adding music to your videos. And with soundtrack, you can choose how many minutes and seconds you want to add, and then start your editing by managing or extending the soundtrack that's available over here. So clicking on open, this is where we can open any previously worked on and saved sessions, which will be saved in the format .stro, which is the Filmstro's proprietary file extension. And these are the files that can get again imported back into Filmstro. Now this has the advantage of where we can share these stro file type files with our peers, team members, so that they can input it back into their Filmstro and then start editing. So this way you can collaborate with multiple team members. Alright, so now let's do a sample editing with a soundtrack. So here's a demo track with the video and the audio, and this audio can also be replaced with whatever you have over here by just simply dragging and dropping the track into this and editing the way you want it. So here is the bass track for this video. So you can see that the momentum is pretty low here, and
I saw it.
Depth is high.
Server down 2 hours?
And the power goes up here towards the end. Now I'm going to pause this video here and then see and show you how the momentum can be increased by just clicking here and then increasing it the way we want it, and then gradually to make it increase even higher towards the end of the video. And the depth is pretty high, so this we can reduce to. And the video volume is also fully high. I'm going to keep this also a little bit lower, and the soundtrack is gradually increasing as well. Let's improve that. I'm just doing this for the demo purpose. As it is, the sound sounds really good, but to show you how these sliders work here, we are going to test this out. Now let me play the video again. You can see the momentum increases over here, and that
you saw it, right?
You can also note the slider slowly rising up.
2 hours?
Let's increase this fully.
Too, so I could add a front row seat to them soiling their pants.
Yeah, but then the light on the webcam would have come on.
Now let's get this down.
It was so grateful when their website came back. Well, my site.
What about the video volume? Let's get it done totally. You can see that the audio, the voice over has come down totally. Let's now decrease the depth as well. Do you see the note? Do you see the difference here? Let's get the momentum down. If you can observe. And the power goes up now.
Yes, Ray. We got the money. What's wrong with my sight then? What's wrong with my sight?
Alright, so I'm gonna pause here and then show all of these completely raised up. So the depth is up, momentum is up as well. Okay, and the power up. And the video volume up. Now you will easily see the difference of how it sounds when we have them all working at the same time.
Very talented, Murray. The juice makes you sloppy. And your amazing dummy sight?
What's wrong with it?
I'll have a car pick you up in the morning. Yes, Ray. We got the money.
What's wrong with my sight then? What's wrong with my sight?
Now let's see if we can get that "what's wrong with my sight" volume totally down. So it's not audible of what he's shouting, but you only get to hear the powerful music in the background. Okay, I've got the video volume down totally, and let's hear. The momentum is up, the depth is up, power, let's get it up completely here. And now the sound volume is up as well, except for the video's volume, which is totally low. Let's hear it out from here. So the voiceover is now not audible, just the music. If at all, if you need in this case to amplify the story's audio. So that's how we can have the audio tracks customized the way we want it. As you might have observed, the video's original volume got reduced here totally, and then we could amplify the depth, power and momentum of this track the way we wanted it. And this way we can alter the music tracks whatever we want here the way we want it. Now here are some lo-fi beats as a sample. Hear them out. I have some downloaded already, so let's hear them out here. Do you see the difference here when we change the depth and power? So that's the difference when we get the momentum out of it. And when you have them all, this is how it sounds. That's how we can customize that. So multiple variations can be created from the same single track. Let's hear this one out. Pretty neat music. Really good. So this is how we can customize. So once done, we can either have these automated time points deleted or have them customized, and then if it's to your liking, then you can click on this export button and it'll ask you for options like, do you want to export all of your audio or just the soundtrack or the video? So you can choose whatever you want, and I would choose all audio, and then that gets saved as a wave saved in the wave format, which can then be imported into our video projects or any other editing projects, where editing tool or software where you can add them to your videos and then have that production done. Finally, speaking of some improvements, I could only think of a couple of them. First, the selection of tracks is pretty limited, but they are growing every single week. Secondly, there is a section of people who may feel challenging about the entire concept of what Filmstro does, and they are perhaps correct in a way, but there is no solution to that because it's just the mindset. Quote unquote, it discourages hardworking composers and encourages lazy filmmakers who don't truly value original music in their projects. Plus, it creates a sense of sameness across films and projects. Now, that's not my opinion, but that's an opinion I found on the website. But if you see, if at all we are working on a tune to customize that to our liking, then there are very little chances that the sameness might come into this picture, because every song might sound different depending on what momentum and depth and power we are going to use and which part of the music is going to be used. I hope you found Filmstro useful for your needs. If you're keen in knowing what Filmstro is working on currently and what plans do they have for the near future in terms of their development, here's their public roadmap. Until next time, I'm Arun from Tech Library TV. Thanks for joining me and spending your precious time watching this video. You take care. Bye.